In this video, we will get started with the Hurst Cycles indicator by performing an analysis on an instrument. The first thing to understand is that the Hurst Cycles indicator will scan all of the timeframes that you have shown it you are interested in. How do you show it that you're interested in a timeframe? Well, that's what we're going to cover in this video. When an analyst performs an analysis of any market using Hurst Cycles, the first thing they do is they start with the big picture. So they start with the longest time frame that they have available to them. In the MetaTrader 4 platform, the longest time frame that we have available to us is the monthly time frame, which is this button over here, MN. And so to get the best analysis out of the Hurst Cycles indicator, you would like the indicator to start its consideration of the analysis with the monthly time frame. Now, before we apply the Hurst Cycles indicator to any charts, we want to make sure that MetaTrader 4 has the data for all the time frames that we are interested in. And so we click on this MN button, and MetaTrader 4 very quickly accesses the monthly data for this instrument, which in this case is the euro to US dollar. Now that we have monthly data, we want to make sure that we can go to the next shorter time frame, which is the weekly chart. So we click on the W1 button to load weekly data for the same instrument. MT4 very quickly loads up that data. Sometimes you will see a message indicating that it is waiting for the data, but usually it loads it very quickly. From the weekly chart, we then step down to the daily chart. From the daily chart, we go down to the H4 or 4-hour chart. You will notice as MT4 loads the data, it will sometimes display some slightly out-of-date data, and then it loads the latest data, so you'll see a bit of a flickering on that chart. Let's go to the H1 data, the hourly chart, and then the M30, the half-hour chart, M15, the 15-minute chart, M5, and finally M1. That whole process takes only 10 to 15 seconds, but now we are confident that the MT4 platform has the data for all of the timeframes. As a matter of interest, you don't have to show the Hurst Cycles indicator all of the timeframes. But the important thing is that you start your analysis with the longest time frame that you want the Hurst Cycles indicator to consider. Some people might choose that to be the daily time frame. That means that the Hurst Cycles indicator will start its analysis on the daily time frame. There really isn't any benefit to that, however, so I would recommend that you always start with the monthly time frame. You have the data, it's free, so why not analyze it? So having run through each one of the timeframes and making certain that the trading platform has data for each of those timeframes, we then switch to the longest timeframe that you want the Hurst Cycles indicator to consider, which I recommend is the monthly timeframe. Now all we do is we apply the Hurst Cycles indicator onto this chart. There are various ways of doing this, you probably know. One of the easiest is simply to drag the indicator from the navigator onto the chart. The indicator shows its inputs and various other details. We'll cover the inputs in a later video. For now, we're going to leave those inputs at the default values, so we're not going to change any of them. The only thing you need to be absolutely certain about at this point is that you have allowed DLL imports. If you haven't allowed DLL imports by default on your trading platform, then you must please make sure that this box is ticked, allow DLL imports. Otherwise, the indicator won't work. Okay, so we're going to go ahead with the default inputs. So I click on the OK button, and the indicator very quickly starts performing an analysis, as you can see. There are the diamonds and the circles and whiskers on your monthly chart. And it will place a message at the top left of the chart. If you take a look at that label at the top left of the chart, you will see that the indicator tells us it has done the monthly chart initiation. That means it has started the analysis on the monthly chart. It also tells us, and let me just move this navigator out of the way so that we can read that message, it tells us that it has analyzed cycles of length 12.4 months up to 17.9 years. It tells us the date and time that it performed the analysis, and in square brackets after that, it tells us how long the analysis took, which you can see is, in this case, 0.03 of a second. That's a pretty fast analysis, I'm sure you will agree. Now, you might already, as a Hurst Cycles analyst, want to start getting involved in this analysis and start studying it and thinking about changing it. But we're not going to discuss that in this video. There are ways of doing that. But for the purposes of getting started with your analysis, we're simply going to move on. Having performed an analysis on our monthly chart, we then click on the W1 button to change the time frame of the chart to a weekly chart. So I click on that button, and you will see the label tells us that the analysis is scheduled. The reason for that is because the Hurst Cycles indicator does require some processing power, and so it schedules its analysis so that it doesn't interfere with anything else happening on the trading platform. And it then, very quickly in this case, performs its analysis. You can see that the label is telling us at the moment that it has done the W1 initiation. It has completed the initiation on the weekly chart. It has now performed an analysis ranging from 17.3 weeks up to 17.9 years. That's the date and time that it did it. And the average analysis time is 0.02 of a second. So it's speeding up. Now that we've done the initiation on the weekly chart, we switch to the next shorter time frame. The next shorter time frame is the D1 time frame, or the daily time frame. So let's click on that button. Now you can see the label is telling us that it has loaded the analysis and it has already performed the analysis on the daily chart. It has now analyzed cycles in the market from a length of 12.5 days up to 17.9 years. That's a pretty comprehensive analysis that it has performed on this particular instrument, and you can see that the average duration of the analysis is 0.05 of a second. Let's step down to the next shorter time frame, the 4-hour time frame. Again, the label will give us information. It tells us that it has loaded the analysis, as you can see, and in a second or two it will have performed the updated analysis. There we go. We had a few messages that flew by fairly quickly, but as you can see, it has now done the 4-hour initiation. It has analysis on this chart ranging from 2.63 days up to 17.9 years. The average analysis time is 0.05 of a second. Now, you might be getting a little bored of this process. We've stepped through 4 time frames. The good news is we only have to actually show the indicator one more time frame. That's the hourly time frame. At that point, you will have a complete analysis and you can do whatever you like. So let's step through to the hourly time frame, the H1 button over here. And again, the indicator loads the analysis that it has. And now it has completed the H1 initiation. And before I finish saying that, it then updated the analysis. So in fact, the indicator did two things there. First of all, it completed the initiation on the 1-hour chart. Then, because it was now looking at hourly data, it was able to go further and go all the way down to the deepest level of data that it has available to us, which, as you know, is the 1-minute data, because we did make sure that the trading platform had 1-minute data before we applied the indicator to the chart. And it has therefore now updated the analysis, and you have a complete analysis on this chart. The cycles which have been analyzed range in duration from 22.2 minutes all the way up to 17.9 years. That's a really comprehensive analysis. That is the date and time that the analysis was performed, and you can see that the average analysis time is about 0.5 seconds. Why is that analysis time crept up? Well, because it has had to do some more complex analysis as it gets into the intraday realm. I'll be explaining more about that in future videos, but for now, that is the analysis that we have available to us on this chart. We can now step down to the half-hour chart if we like, and you will notice that the indicator tells us that the analysis has been loaded, and we have the same duration of the cycles for the analysis range, and everything else is the same. You can see that when we switched to the 30-minute chart, there was no extra analysis to be done. That is because the Hurst Cycles indicator constantly updates the analysis as and when it needs it. So when we switch time frames, it simply loads the analysis, and it understands that it doesn't need to update this analysis. Let's step down to the 15-minute time frame. Again, the analysis is loaded, but there is no further analysis performed. We can step down to the 5-minute time frame. Now we're seeing these intraday cycles. You can see the white cycle, which is on average about a 5-hour cycle, and there's the purple cycle, which is about a 90-minute cycle on average. Of course, cycles expand and contract, so the average wavelengths of those cycles will change. Let's step down to the 1-minute time frame, and now we can see our analysis going all the way down to the shortest cycle, which is that red cycle, which is on average about 25 minutes in length. As you can see on this particular analysis at the moment, the peak analysis is showing us an average length of 22.2 minutes, and the trough analysis is showing us an average length of 23.3 minutes. Now we can jump around between the different time frames and we can study our analysis. In future videos, I'm going to be speaking about these circles and whiskers and what their meaning is and how to interpret them. But isn't it interesting? Let's have a look at perhaps the 30-minute chart. Isn't it interesting that we have a circle and whiskers for the peak of the 5-day cycle in this case? And just 2 bars later, a peak formed in the market. That is the tremendous power of Hurst cycles. Now you have a complete Hurst cycles analysis for the euro to US dollar. And you can switch between these different time frames as you like, and you can study the analysis on the different time frames. You can zoom in and out on your charts, and you can see greater or less detail depending on what you want. And the Hurst cycles indicator will take care of your analysis for you. There is really absolutely nothing that you need to do. If you are an experienced Hurst cycles analyst, then of course you can change the analysis if you like. But for now, in terms of getting started, that's really all we need to do. There's one other thing I'd like to point out to you before we finish this video, and that is that the label at the top left of the chart is changing color. When it started out, it was a white label. You might have noticed it's been gradually changing color over time as I've been speaking, and at the moment it's a kind of a yellow color. And if I switch again to a time frame, that yellow color remains. The color of the label tells us how much time has elapsed since the previous analysis was performed. After an analysis is updated or performed, the label is white in color. It then gradually turns into a yellow color, then it will turn orange, and eventually it will turn red. The indicator will update its analysis approximately every 10 minutes. So what I'm going to do is speed up this video a little bit, and we can see how the label changes color, eventually goes red, and then the Hurst cycles indicator will update its analysis. Of course, it doesn't matter what time frame we're on when the analysis is updated, because the indicator will consider all time frames. So let's switch to the 5-minute time frame and watch things on the 5-minute time frame as we are approaching the next time for the analysis. And there we go. The indicator has updated its analysis, as you can see from that label. Analysis was updated. We still have the same range of cycles, of course, and that's the time at which it was updated. And our average time for each analysis is 0.2 seconds. I'll be speaking about all of those details further in future videos. But for now, we have got started. We have an analysis for the euro to US dollar. Now, I know you might be thinking, do I have to do this every time I create a new chart for the euro to US dollar? No, you have now done this for the euro to US dollar. So let's create another chart, and we do that by simply doing that. Now that we have a new chart, I'm going to apply a template. And MetaTrader 4 applies this template, and as you can see, it simply loads that analysis onto our hourly chart. We can zoom in and out, and we can explore the analysis, and we can, of course, change the time frames for this chart as well. You can create as many charts as you like for the euro to US dollar, and if you load your Hurst Cycles indicator, they will all have access to the analysis that is being performed in the euro to US dollar, and they will all have the same analysis on them. There is a lot more detail to be explained, of course, but in terms of this video, we are done. You have got started and applied your Hurst Cycles indicator onto an instrument in MetaTrader 4.